Good morning, afternoon, evening, or good night, composers. This is Mr. Joel here again with another workshop on an aspect of composing that is very important to be thinking about when you are writing your own music. Today we're going to be talking about a thing called structure. Have you heard this word structure before? I've heard it when I'm thinking about building a house, for example. That's a structure. It's a kind of a building. And when you build a house, you have to have a certain kind of way about going about creating that structure. You have to have the foundation at the bottom, then you have to have the wood that goes on top, and you have to have the frames that are usually some form of aluminum or steel, and then the walls that go on, and then from there you have all the appliances and the wallpaper and painting and furniture, and so it's all kind of stacked up in order so that the structure is firm and it doesn't fall apart. We actually have something very similar in music, and we call it structure. It's the way that we sequence, that we order different parts of music, different parts of a piece, so that when you play it from beginning to end, there's a relationship between the beginning, the middle, and the end of music. And we call it ABA. And what that means is that the first part, the A, has a certain quality to the music, sounds a certain way, feels a certain way. Then the B often is different. And then we go back to an A that is either exactly the same as the first one, or it's similar, at least, that it has a similar kind of feeling or vibe or something along those lines. So we're gonna talk today about different pieces all across music that have ABA form, and then at the end, we're gonna be doing a little bit of creating our own ABA music composition. Let's start off with a piece that you may be familiar with called The Yellow Submarine.
In the town where I was born.
So in popular music, you might call this a verse, and you can also think of it as like an A. Listen to this music for a moment. Think about the melody. Think about the music. Now get ready, because it's gonna change. We're gonna go to a B. And this B in popular music we call the chorus. It's kind of like the main part. Here's the B. Now what happens next? Well, ABA. We go back to an A. See how this melody is very similar to how the song started? And then they do something a little different here just for fun, because we can always bend the rules and break the rules. That's part of what makes art art. But notice again how the song starts.
In the town where I was born.
And then in the middle we have that. This middle part here, the B. And then we have the A again. So we have ABA structure, even in popular music like Yellow Submarine. Now this happened, this structure was very popular during the Baroque period of music, which was around the early to mid 1600s. So we're talking maybe 400 years ago or so, maybe a little less. And around that time, music was often about the players and the virtuosity, the impressiveness of the players. So there would be ABA pieces where players would play the first part, and then they would play a different part, and then they would play kind of the first part again, but they would add their own personal spin on it. They would solo on top of it. They would kind of do their own thing with it. So this is a piece called Recorder Concerto in F major, and this is the first movement of it called Allegro. And recorder concerto, you might know this word recorder because you or maybe an older sibling or a younger sibling have played recorder in your schools perhaps. And this is a piece for that recorder. Can you hear the recorder?
Mm-hmm.
pause because that part right there, that's the beginning. You can see where I am if you could look right down here on the mouse tracker. We're just right at the very beginning of the piece. Now, what if I go to the very end? And I'm so sorry I didn't pre-cue what the timestamp was, but let's see if we can find toward the very end of the piece now, skipping all the way to the end. Look where we are right now. Does this sound familiar? That's because it's the A again. So we have the A at the beginning, and we have the A at the end. So once again, we have this very beginning part. Right over here. And then if I bring the mouse tracker over to right around here. And here we are again. We have another A. How interesting, right? So we start and end kind of the same way. Now what's in the middle? Well, that's the B. What do you think it's gonna sound like? Is it gonna sound the same as what we were listening to already, or is it gonna sound different? Let's pick a random place kind of right in the middle here. This is somewhere in the middle of the B. Let's hear it. Ooh, dramatic. So that middle part sounds pretty dramatic to me. Sounds like very flourishy, and the recorder player gets to really show off their chops. So in this piece, it sounds like the composer put the B section as a very complicated and interesting part for the player. And then we come sort of back to home base at that end with that nice A. And that's from 400-ish years ago. That's Recorder Concerto in F by Giuseppe Sammartini. Now, this also happened in the classical period with melodies. Even just a nice 45-second melody, you can hear a version of ABA in that. Here is a very famous melody that I'm sure you're familiar with. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. Now, this piece is also called A vous dirige, maman. I'm speaking to you, mom, in French, and it's by Mozart. This melody is different, right? And then we have that A again. So I didn't really set that up right away. Let me explain that one more time. So we have this melody here that we know so well. And once again, we're right around here on the track. So what happens if I go to the end of the track and play the last part? It's the same melody, with a little bit of a flourish at the end for the player to show off some of their chops. So look at that! Twinkle, twinkle, little star! That was at least 100, I should have looked up the dates in advance, shouldn't I? It was something around 70, 80 years after the last piece we played. So even 80 years later, when the length of time for a baby to turn into a grandma, they're still using the same idea. They're still starting a piece one way, going somewhere different, and then ending the piece the same way they began. A, B, A. Let's jump forward in time to 1950. So we're jumping ahead to 200 years-ish later in time. This is about 70 years ago, when maybe your grandma or your grandpa was a baby, and this is in the genre of jazz. And in jazz music, we also do a very similar thing, where we start off with what's called the head, and that's sort of the main theme of the piece. And then, in the middle, we do what's called the solos, where the players get to kind of show off their chops. And then at the end, we go back to the head. So again, it's A, B, A. Head, solo, head is what they called in jazz. They have their own terminology for it, but it's a version of ABA. Let's listen to a little bit of Freddy Freeloader by Miles Davis. So this is that A, right? Mm-hmm. what instruments these are? Alright, here's the B. Solos. What instrument is this? Now this B goes for quite some time because a lot of different players get to play. I'm gonna jump ahead, apologies to the players on this piece. We're going to listen to a couple other instrumental moments in this B section. So here's another part of the B. Ooh, what instrument is this? That's a trumpet. Let's hear the next instrument for a moment. Saxophone. So you get the idea. This is the B section. All of this is the B section. A chance for the soloists to solo off and show off their abilities to play, which is what we call chops. Let's go to the end of the piece now and see what happens at the end. What do you think is going to happen? I wonder. Here we go. So here's the ending part. Let's see what happens. I'm right here now. We get another A. So quick recap, very beginning, 0 seconds in. Over here. And then all the way at the very end, 9 minutes in. I'll rewind just a little bit. There's. And there we go again, 9 minutes in. So we have the same thing, A, B, A. So why don't we go ahead and compose our original A, B, A pieces. And like I said, as a composer, you can use this idea of A, B, A however you want to. You don't have to always do like A that's a certain way, B that's totally different than A that's the same except the player gets to add their own things. That's a common way to do it, but you can do it like some of these people did it where it's like A, and then B is like the show-off place, and then A is kind of like just the same again as the first A, kind of like home base. So why don't we go ahead and compose an A, B, A melody? And in my last video, I used my voice. So this time, I think I'm going to use a guitar. But you can use your voice. You can use a piano if you have it. Or maybe you have a guitar or something like a guitar, like a ukulele or something at home. So let's see about using this guitar to make our melody. Let's see. I'm just gonna peek at the camera, make sure that y'all can kind of see where I'm at. Yeah, maybe I'll stand up for this part. Can you see me? Am I too high? Let's see. All right. So, why don't I compose the melody? Maybe the first part of the melody is going to use the low string down here. And then the B, because it's got to be different, it's going to use the high string. And then the third one, the A again, it's going to use the low string again. So let's see. So I'm just pinching along different parts of the string and trying out different parts that sound good to me. And then I'll do the same thing with this part. So let's see. Over here, and I'm plucking with my thumb down here. How about the second part? It's kind of neat. Okay. to do? An A. And there's my A, B, A melody. Let's do one more time. You're gonna hear all three parts, the A, the B, and then the A one last time. Wrong note. Here we go. And there's my ABA melody. Maybe you can compose an ABA melody and send it off to us so we can see it. I would love to see the beginning, the middle, and the end of your ABA melodies. You can sing it. You can play it on an instrument. You could even do rhythm ABA melodies if you wanted. You can compose rhythmically. Maybe the A is, and then the B is, and then the A is. So if you want to use your rhythm skills, you can use your rhythm skills too. Well, composers, I can't wait to see what you come up with your ABA melodies. And I hope that this was informative, that you could see the way that ABA has been used all across the history of music from hundreds of years ago all the way up to now. Thanks, composers. Have a great one. Bye.